Smart contract developers are in high demand, drawing one of the highest salaries in the developer community. And now it's never been easier to become a smart contract developer on Algorand. Hello everyone, my name is Chris, and today I'm going to go over how to set up your development environment with AlgoKit, write a simple Algorand smart contract with Beaker and PyTeal, and deploy and call your smart contract using Dapflow, all in only 10 minutes. A quick note before we get started, I'll be using macOS for this tutorial, but I'll leave a link on how to set up your development environment in Windows, along with all the links I mentioned in the description. Also, there are some prerequisites that you need to install before following along this video. The prerequisites are Python 3.10 or higher, pipx, Git, and Docker. If you want a full walkthrough of installing these prerequisites, you can find the development environment setup videos in the description. Now let's install AlgoKit, the all-in-one development tool for Algorand developers. With AlgoKit, you'll be able to set up your development environment, your project folder, and start building your dream project with only one command. To install AlgoKit, open up your terminal and type in pipx install AlgoKit. This is going to install AlgoKit, and there you go. AlgoKit is installed. Now this command will install AlgoKit globally, so you'll be able to use AlgoKit in any directories. Now to check if AlgoKit installed correctly, let's run AlgoKit --version. If you see something like this, then congratulations, you're ready to start building on Algorand. Now let's create your project folder with AlgoKit. To do that, simply run AlgoKit init. This command will prompt up a series of questions that will ask you on how you want to set up your project folder. The first question is asking me what I want to name my project. And I'm going to call it calculator because that's the smart contract that I'm going to be creating. Then it's asking me to select the project template. I will select Beaker. Then it's asking for my name. I'll write my name, Chris Kim, my email. And then it's going to ask me if I want to add VS Code configuration. Since I'll be using VS Code as my editor, I'll say yes to that. I'll use the rough linter, and I'll say yes to all of these questions. Now here, this question is asking me if I want to run AlgoKit bootstrap. And this command will basically bootstrap your project folder so that you can just get straight to building your project. So I'm going to say yes to that as well. Now this is going to create a Python virtual environment. And inside of that virtual environment, it is going to install all of the dependencies that you will need to write a smart contract on Algorand. And finally, the question is asking me if I want to initialize the Git repository. I'll say yes to that. And there you go. AlgoKit has successfully initialized your project folder. So now you can just go into that folder and start building your smart contract. Now let's go into the created project folder by doing cd calculator. And then open up your editor in that project folder. I'm using VS Code as my editor, so I'll run the suggested command. Okay, now I'm inside VS Code looking at my project folder. Now there are a lot of files here, but the folder that I want you to focus on is the smart contracts folder. Inside the smart contracts folder, AlgoKit init will give you one example smart contract, and that's the Hello World smart contract here. Now for this video, I'm going to create a calculator app, so I'm going to create another file inside of the smart contracts folder called calculator.py. Now first off, you want to import Beaker and PyTeal. Here I'm importing Beaker as BK and PyTeal as PT. Then let's create the application by using the application class from Beaker, and we're going to name this application calculator and assign this to the app variable. Now this calculator is a weird calculator, so the only thing it can do is to add. This add method takes in two arguments, A and B. Both A and B are ABI UN64 type. Now this star here is saying anything on the left of the star is an argument for this method, and anything on the right of the star is an output for this method. And then as the output, we are saying that the output is also an ABI UN64 type. Now we have this app.external decorator here, and what this is doing is it's exposing the add method to the ABI so that the front end knows how to call this method. Now inside the method, the first thing we're going to do is add A and B, and then assign that to the addResult variable. Now we're going to have to use the get method here to get the value of the arguments a and b. And then in line 9, we're going to return the output set to the add result. Now this calculator has another feature where it stores the latest calculation in the global state, where global state is state recorded on the application that is accessible by everyone. To do that, we first need to define a Python class for the state. Here I have a class named myState, and inside the class, I have a result variable that is set equal to the global state value, where the global state is a teal type UN64 type, so it's a number. After defining your state class, you want to instantiate it inside the application class as a second argument, and then assign that equal to state. Now the calculator application has access to the state inside of myState class. Now we want to store the latest calculation during the add method execution. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a sequence where the first thing we do inside of the sequence is to set the add result value to the result state that we defined up here. And then we're going to set the add result as the output. Now that we have a functionality to store the state, we need a method to read the state. And that's what this read result method is doing. It doesn't take any arguments, but as an output, it's going to output a UN64 type, and it's going to return the application state result. Now all this method is doing is reading some value from the global state. That's why it has the read-only parameter set equal to true. Now that's a completed smart contract for this weird calculator that we have. It has a function to add, and it has a function to store the latest calculation in global state. Now let's compile this code and then deploy an interact method using Dapflow. To do that, we're going to use the build method inside of the application class provided by Beaker to build out the application spec and compile this Beaker and PyTeal smart contract code into Teal code. And then we're going to export the spec inside of the artifacts folder. Now let's save this, open up a terminal, go into the smart contracts folder, then run the calculator.py file. Now if you open up the Explorer and look at our folder, we will see the artifacts folder created. And inside the artifacts folder, you will see 4 files, where 2 of these files are Teal source code for your smart contract, and contract.json file is the ABI specification of your smart contract. This application.json file is an extended version of your ABI. Here I mentioned Teal, and Teal is a low-level assembly language that the AVM takes and executes. So if we take a look at approval.teal, this is the Teal source code auto-generated by your Beaker and PyTeal smart contract. So this is the code that the AVM actually takes and understands. And then I said that the contract.json file is an ABI, and ABI stands for Application Binary Interface. And this ABI file will have all of the information that the front end or other smart contracts need to know in order to interact with this smart contract. So think of it like an instruction for your front end or other smart contracts. Now, during development of your smart contract, you want to be testing your code in a local private blockchain to quickly test your code and debug your code. To launch a private local Algorand blockchain on your computer, open up your terminal, and then run algokit localnet start. After running that command, head over to Docker, and if you see algokit sandbox running 3 containers, the algod, Postgres, and indexer, then you have successfully launched a private local Algorand blockchain on your computer. Now let's finally head over to Dapflow to deploy and interact with your smart contract. To do that, you can run algokit explore to directly open up Dapflow from your terminal. Now, algokit explore should have automatically configured your Dapflow environment to SANDNet. But if it didn't, click on this button right here, click sandbox, and then click save. Now, first thing you want to do is you want to create a dev wallet for testing. Click dev wallets, click create wallet, and then dispense some test algos to play around with. And then click connect wallet, and then connect your dev wallet. Now, head over to ABI Studio, and then import in the ABI file. Click import ABI. Click File, Upload File, head over to your project folder, go inside of Smart Contracts folder, go into Artifacts, and then import in the contract.json file. Now just by importing in the ABI, Dapflow knew the name of the smart contract and what kind of methods the smart contract has. Now that's the beauty of ABI. Now to deploy it, click Create App, click Bear. When you deploy Algorand smart contracts, you need to define how much state the smart contract uses. Now for our calculator app, it uses one global int value. So I'll say 0 for the global bytes, 1 for global ints, and 0 for both local bytes and local ints. Then upload your approval program here. Upload your clear program, which are all inside of the artifacts folder, and then click create. Now, if you see this message right here, application created successfully, then you have successfully deployed your smart contract in your private local blockchain. Now let's execute the add method and add 10 plus 10. And if I click execute, you can see that the return value is 20 and the method executed successfully. You can view the transaction by clicking on this button as well. Now let's check if our smart contract has correctly stored the latest calculation inside of global state. To do that, let's head over to read result and execute the method. And as you can see, the read result method also returned value 20. Now that's how you use Dapflow to quickly deploy your smart contract and test out your code. And that's it. Today we covered how to set up your development environment using AlgoKit, how to write a simple Algorand smart contract with Beaker and PyTeal, and how to deploy and call your smart contract using Dapflow. Now this video is too short to cover all of the powerful features of Algorand smart contracts, but stay tuned for a complete video series on PyTeal, Beaker, Teal, and other Algorand Layer 1 features and become a master Algorand developer. Hopefully this video has taught you how to start developing on the Algorand blockchain, and I look forward to seeing you build your application on Algorand.